I actually just realized this was supposed to be wider. I should probably fix that. I gotta get rid of all this stuff. This is very hard to make. What's up, everybody? I'm IGP, and welcome back to Raft. I know a lot of you have been asking, where the hell is Raft? Well, here it is. Basically, I had a project in mind, something I wanted to accomplish in Raft, and dedicate a lot of time doing it. So for a while, I've been building up resources in order to be able to do that. And what I want to do is build a rather large pirate ship. Now, I know that we don't have all of the tools necessary to make an authentic one, but I think we can make it look as authentic as possible. And I'm going to build it right about where that shark is. It's going to be massive. Now, I've already got a nice little foundation right here and behind me as well. I'll explain all that in just a second. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, my foundation is as such. This is going to be our bay right over here. So I'm going to be able to walk over here and then go up a ramp that's going to go to the top of our ship. I might do two, depending on how big I want to make this thing. But yeah, it's going to be awesome. It's going to be sitting over here, so we have a nice view of it. This over here, I'll explain this in a second, but this, oh god, fell in the water. This right here is my little storage mansion. Looks like a house. This is what kind of gave me the idea that we can do it. You can kind of make these shapes, and they're not like the best looking things, but again, it can definitely look authentic if you put some effort into it. Hopefully in future updates we have more building options, but for now, we're gonna use what we got. So I have protection around this entire place, and you can see there's chests everywhere. They're not full. Trust me, they are not full. They could be more full. I have a bunch of resources here, but I put this out here just because the shark is a nuisance, and if he does try to attack this place, he'll have to go through two instead of just one. Whoop, I'm dying. Drink up, dudes. I need to plant some more seeds too, but we'll get to that. Anyway, so inside the little storage house, we have chests full of stuff I've made. We have thatch, rope, scrap metal, and a bunch of wood that I've saved up over time. And if you go upstairs, this is the more important stuff. I have a whole chest, two chestfuls of coconuts. So I'm never gonna run out. And I don't need to have, as you notice, I didn't have any water or food thing, because I really don't need it. This entire thing is going to supply my food and water forever. But the idea of this is to have as much storage as possible. Clearly, I don't need all this. It's going to take a long while to fill all this stuff up. However, and now going back to this point, these are all building up. Look, 32 items, blah, blah, blah. Like, this is unlimited. And I also figured out that there's a certain range that the items will come in from. Basically, the range that I've set here is where you're going to see the most items. You might have one or two come by, like, in 3 hours this way, but overall, the concentration of the items coming in is this length. So if you're ever building a base, don't build out too wide. You're not going to get many items out that way. What is this shark doing? Get out of here. And this is our little palm area. I think I have some more seeds I want to plant. No, I think we're good. Nope, here's one. And we can cut these down eventually, but I don't need them right now. Of course, I could just do this at any point, but, yeah. So this is how I've collected all this stuff currently. And I do know, I'm very much aware, because I've used Cheat Engine before on different games. I'm very much aware you can make this into a creative mode, but it kind of took away, like, by the time I realized, oh yeah, I could probably do that in this game, by the time that happened, I'm like, I've already invested so much time, not really, like, actual time, but just kind of standby time, into this. It would feel much better if I build this thing legitimately, so that's what I'm gonna do. Maybe next episode, we can get creative, enable the creative mode, and then we can just go ape shit and build stuff. Maybe we can continue with this place. Maybe the pirate ship will be here, and then maybe back here will be a village where the pirate ship has come and docked, and now he can visit. I don't know. And, yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and build our stuff out this way, I think. I'm thinking, like, probably right here should be fine. Now, what's the problem with this is I'm gonna have to lay down foundation as a base for the pirate ship. What I'm thinking is taking the stairs and turning them inwards, even though there's pillars that kind of show, it'll still give it that curvature that I'm going for. So let me get the stairs over here. All right, so this ramp is gonna go up into it. I think this is a nice height. I don't see why not. We can make a small one and then expand upon it, maybe? Or should I go up twice? Nah, that's about right. I think that's right. Now, I don't want this son of a bitch coming in here and destroying my staircase. So I'm just gonna do this real quick. And if you haven't noticed, I've been rotating them because they look so much better when they're rotated. It looks like something special instead of a straight, you know, boards this way. It just doesn't make any sense. Anyway, up here, let's go ahead and start. Oh, look at this bastard, dude. He knows. All right, do me a favor and fuck off, dude. Oh my god. I was too late. That's fine. It's almost, there's no point in killing the shark. He's gonna destroy your stuff, and then you could just bloop, plop it right back down. I'm running out of wood. I need to go get more wood. Of course, I could pick all this up, but, you know, sometimes when you pick this stuff up, like 38 items, it fills up your inventory and then just goes and spits out all these little barrels, and it's kind of a nuisance. Anyway, let me get some more wood. All right, so let's go ahead and lay down the foundation for our pirate ship here. We're gonna need it, pretty much all, I think, covering the entire area. I don't think there's any way around that. Now, what I could do is make this thing float in a way. So we're gonna go and put this here, right? And then we can just destroy this, right? Because we can put the pillar right here and then floors, right? Which I will rotate the same direction. So we're gonna be able to go up here and then this part can be, we could even extend it a little bit. There we go. So this one, if it gets attacked, that's gonna suck because both of that, all of that gets destroyed. So hopefully the shark gets hungry for something else out of the millions of boards he could possibly choose from. So now we have a separate thing here, and I kind of messed up, but you can actually have separate rafts in the game. I mean, you've probably seen that demonstrated by the shark destroying, like, a walkway. But here we are. So this is going to be our pirate ship, and it's going to be very hard to try to make this work, but I'm thinking I'm going to just go ahead and set down the foundation to the length that I like, and then continue on from there. It doesn't have to be huge. The purpose is just to make it. And I want to make it as even as possible. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 out from 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I'm out of wood. Man, this is going to be tough. Good thing I have all these resources. Don't get me. All right. Don't fuck with my pirate ship, dude. I'm trying to make something beautiful here. I'm just gonna go ahead and pick up this stuff. I'm sure there's tons of wood in here. Actually, I didn't get that much. Oh my god. Let me just go ahead and collect some of this and store it away. Oh, there we go. Huh. It's scary almost. Oh, where? Back off, dude. Nuh-uh. So I don't know if he's programmed to actually go to the places he's destroyed or taken damage from. That would be the smart thing to do as a shark, but he's dumb. Let me get some more coconuts inside me. There we go. And move on. So I don't have to cut down these trees for a while. It's gonna be a long while before I need to do that. All right, back to our ship. We're gonna go to foundation and lay down more of it. How much did I have now? So it was 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think that's fine. So we don't need it very wide, I guess, but we do need it 3 in. So I'm thinking, and I'll show you in a second what I'm thinking of, is doing stairs like this to give the curvature of the bottom or the interior of it. You know what I mean? We'll see how it looks. Good lord, I need a lot of stuff. All right, so yeah, I think I actually like that. That looks really good. And I know I can see the sides of it, but it definitely gives that curvature, and then when it's closed off, it'll be darkened a bit, you know what I mean? So, it's better than nothing. I don't want a square pirate ship, you know? Maybe it's a pirate ship in the works. Maybe they're building on it, and that's why it looks that way. All right, so I laid down the basic foundation for the shape of this thing. It's not going to be perfect, as you can see. I might actually end up putting walls up here, but I don't know. I like the way it curves. You know, you can see the curve of it. It's a little bit above water, but you know what? It still kind of looks like the bottom of a ship. So the idea is to not be able to go to the bottom anyway. So as you can see, I can't do much about that part. You see, there's like extra area. Like, I want to be able to block that off and then go into it. The problem is, again, there's not enough room to set down another pillar because it's only one adjacent to it, so a 3x3 area, which I can't actually cover properly. Otherwise, I would cover this up completely, but closing it off with walls still kind of looks good. So this would be like the lower deck, the bottom deck where all the scrubbies, or whatever the word is for the guys that work at the bottom. That's where they would go, and then this would go up to the top of the ship, and then we're gonna make a giant mast once we get this done. This is gonna be very difficult to make work, but we can definitely do it. If anyone can do it, it's us. So right now I'm just closing off what I can, Again, it's not going to be perfect. We're not given all the tools in order to be able to make this work properly, but hopefully we can get something that looks aesthetically pleasing. So this is going to be the front, and I'm going to try to decorate it the best I can, and then back here is going to be the bay at which it's operating. The steering wheel, I guess. Now, I'm trying to figure out how to enclose this, because there's pretty much no way I can do that unless I put a whole bunch of pillars on the sides here, which I guess I could do. I actually just realized this was supposed to be wider. I should probably fix that. I gotta get rid of all this stuff. This is very hard to make. All right, so I know I'm hard cutting a lot of this stuff out, but I'm sure you guys don't want to see the absolute grind that I'm doing right now. I made this little pathway so I can escape the bottom. I made a little outside part to give it some contour, but yeah, so it's gonna give this like kind of contoured in shape. I should get rid of that bottom to have that kind of sticking out, but I'll mess with that later. Right now, I'm just focusing on the interior. So we got this all done. I've extended it out, and we have the other side pretty much ready to go. I'm going to wall this up, and then here's the deck. It is open as fuck, and then we'll have a raised deck up here. Staircases leading up. This is where the steering wheel is going to be, and then we're going to have the masts out here, and then it's going to come to a point in the front. I need some more resources, though. This stuff's been gathering up, and I'm getting a bunch of seeds from eating all these damn coconuts. Here, I'm gonna gather up all this. Too much stuff, huh? Can I carry any of it? Just have it all? Oh my god. I'm gonna crash the game. Is there stuff flying? Oh my god! It's raining barrels! That's where they go, apparently, when you drop stuff. So apparently I should have already put the walls down because I can't do it when the pillars are there. That's kinda stupid. I mean, just a little bit. The building in this game needs to be worked on in a sense that sometimes I can actually take down a pillar and it doesn't delete the floors above it, which is kind of nice, but I can't depend on that. And sometimes when I actually tried it, it didn't work out so well. Spending a lot of time on this, and probably not many people are gonna see this, but hey, maybe I'll upload the save game and somewhere, and then you guys can check it out for yourself. Because you can kind of do that. I guess you only can do it in version 1.04. But, you know, if the game gets updated, you can't play it. But if you download the old version, which you should be able to do on itch.io anyway, you know, you might be able to pull this one up and play it. I'm going to add to it, of course. If the game gets updated like crazy, I'm probably still going to add to this. Now, let me go ahead and set down these floors as they should be. I think I messed up the pattern somewhere. But I said, you know what? Fuck it, because I'm gonna have to redo all of this. See? What? What? Why'd I do that? There we go. That's all done. Okay. So now, I think we can expand upon this a bit. Because I gotta put pillars on this too. Back up here, but I can't reach, so let me just put the floors down for now. Alright, putting these, this floor down. The deck's gonna be much larger than anticipated. But I think, oop, that one's fine. This one needs to get rid of. See? I keep doing it. Every time I start talking, I mess up something. There we go. Okay, so the deck is done. The deck is done. I have to close this off somehow, which I could probably do pretty easily. All right, so let's put this stuff down so we can officially say this is closed off. All right, so I expanded this a bit because I might have to make this one more wide to make this an even post for the sailing part, the mast. So right now I'm just trying to build some extra stairs so I can get up and actually craft this thing. I have to make it pretty tall, so this is gonna be interesting. Okay, there we go. This is a makeshift staircase with as minimal resources as possible. So put this up here and then connect these three for that little middle part of the mast. And then this, I mean, this is the best we're gonna be able to do. Hopefully it looks good. Man, that looks good. Look at that house. I have to make this a little bit wider. I wonder if I can actually do that. This is the middle, right? I'm trying to find where the middle part is. Okay, so the middle's right here. If I utilize down here, right? And I put this and then one more out, right? If I can reach it, come on. There we go. Okay. And then, just hear me out. Hear me out here. Put this here. I'm out of freaking steel. Damn it! Look at that shark being a bitch, but look at that, though. It almost looks like a jungle gym. Now, we can put the walls, which will act as like the waving sail of sorts. And then we're gonna go up here, and now we can expand it even further out this way for an even bigger one. And then I'm gonna go for the full thing here by doing that. And this will be weird looking, but I think it'll work. I think it might look okay. I'm actually running out of wood completely. I have to keep reloading the game because it's crashed a few times. But, and then when I do that, all the resources gathered here kind of go away, so... it's kind of hard, actually. Alright, and then... one more wall right here. Should do it. Is that it? Yes, that's it. Okay, cool. Now, I don't know how this looks just yet. I do have to actually put the middle post up again. If I can. I gotta make another staircase. It would seem. Then... middle post right there, then floor, then middle post. There we go. Okay, let's start destroying this stuff. At least I know the shark can't get up to the mast and can't mess up my hard work. All right, so let's try. I'm going to put walls here just because I feel like it would be appropriate. The problem I have is that normally a mast is like, I mean, that looks fucking awesome. Normally a mast is, you know, it's pyramid up. But I can't actually do that, at least I don't think, with the structures that I have. I mean, if I want to make it look just one pole in the middle, this is the best I can do. I could reverse it. Like, make it go a little bit more up. You know what I mean? So it'll be wider and then make it narrower up top. As a matter of fact, I could extend this, right? Couldn't I? It doesn't look like I can. No, I can't because there's just the one there. So I could! This is gonna get rid of it, though. I'm so afraid right now. I'm gonna die. I don't have any coconuts. Oh, dude. Look at that. That looks good. But, we can make it look better. Let me go get some coconuts real quick because I'm dying. So what I want to do is make it wider and then narrower up top. So I could extend it just a little bit, and then, yeah, I think I'm gonna do that, so, wish me luck. If I tear this down, will this entire thing get destroyed? Probably. Nope, that was the wall. Duh! Yep, whole thing is gone. Shit. Alright, well, what I could do is pillar here, right? And then floor can go up there, if I can reach there. There, there, and there, okay? And so, the first part can be one, I suppose. I don't see why not. Okay, and then we're gonna put pillars here in the middle, and then over there. And then, extend the floors even more. I'm deleting this now, deleting all this stuff now, and you'll see what I've done. I think it's a major improvement since the first one I did. You can kind of see it already. All right, so let's take a look at my updated mast. Oh yeah, yeah. I think that looks way better. That looks really fucking good. I could have made that post at the top a little bit pointier, but I think it does the job. If I could get rid of those somehow and have that not be destroyed, that would be amazing. But if I got rid of it just to test, it would destroy that entire side, so that would suck. Let's go ahead and step away and take a look. I'm gonna continue this. It's been a very long time. This is a very long recording. Probably about 3 hours or so. Making this ship. But look at that, dude. That looks badass. I will finish this in the next episode. I think I'll continue this. But that, I can very much appreciate that. All the hard work that's put into this. You guys may not think so. Probably like, IGP, why aren't you using creative mode? It would have been much easier. You know what? It feels so much better that I accomplished this without it, you know? So that is the pirate ship in the works. I'm gonna continue on this again in the next episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, you know what to do. Leave your suggestions in the comment section below. I love you all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.